Well, it is 7:13 in the morning on Saturday, race day. I got up early to arrive at the airport, and I'm sitting outside the door. La oficina está no abierto. No sé qué tiempo. But we'll just hang out here until they open it up for us and then go to the aircraft. There's a very passable little rope line there that I can walk out to my aircraft, but there's ominous signs that say, no pasar, do not cross. I don't want to get in trouble. This is a military-controlled airport. I had to cross through the military checkpoint over on that side to get in. So, when in Mexico, do as the Mexicans do. But it should be a good day. Going to throw some cameras on the helmet, on the aircraft. Have this one rolling on the suction cup mount. Got four passengers that want to go to an off-site landing, hang out down at the ranch for a bit, and then pick up and head back to Ensenada by 4 p.m. so that they can get back in their jet and fly away. Not a bad little assignment. Hopefully all the things today go smooth. I'm sure they will. Left Coast Overland fans, my name is Rick, and you are watching the Left Coast Overland. If you guys are tuning in, you are watching this for one reason and one reason only, because you like adventuring. Well, right now I'm configuring my flight helmet to accept the new toy, the GoPro Hero 8. So I'm going to do a little bit of a mini review. I'm actually going to go use this in practical application, because I'm going to mount it to my flight helmet. And we are going to fly a helicopter down to Baja, California in a few days for the Baja 1000 races. And we're going to chase after some cars and have a good time. So we'd like to invite you to guys come along with me. I've got some of my old camera gear here that's made it through the paces for the last few years. That's kept this channel alive. And we decided that we're gonna upgrade to the newest, latest and greatest to mount to the helmet and try and capture some really good footage. So kind of a mini review about the camera and about how I'm gonna configure it to the helmet. And then the rest is just gonna be the trip experience down to Ensenada. So the plan is to decide how to mount this. This is the old Hero 3, as you can see, and I've never actually mounted one to my flight helmet. You'd think that I would have by now, but just never really felt the need until right now. But gonna decide whether I'm gonna mount it to the ear cup here or put it a little bit further up on the helmet, or even do multiple mounting options, right here on the visor cover or something like that. So we'll kind of just play with it, see what works best. And we'll use the application with the viewfinder and set it up. And then I'm also going to have the phone, which is recording right now. I'm going to mount that with a suction cup mount to the aircraft. Inside the aircraft, I obviously wouldn't want to lose my phone. And then I think we use the Hero 3 with the skeleton case mounted to the outside of the aircraft. Being as the Hero 3 is the least valuable camera system, it still works, it still gets decent quality footage. So we put it into the underwater camera housing that was ubiquitous with the old 3s, and we'll mount it to the belly of the aircraft. Not using the suction cup mount, I'll just use one of the sticky mounts, I think, with these guys. And yeah, we'll go from there. So give me a few minutes to configure this thing, play around with it, and then I'll show you what it looks like once it's all stuck to the helmet. And yeah, hopefully we can get some really good footage for you guys. If none of you have seen the Baja races before, it's worth going to. So November and then June. I promise it's not my first time putting this helmet on. Still have full functionality of all the visors and everything, obviously. It's a little sticky. So this thing's all strapped into my head, and
first impressions.
Let me take this big clunky thing off my melon. I like it. It's not, I guess, overly obtrusive, or, you know, I probably won't even notice that it's there. So the biggest thing that I'm worried about is longevity of the battery. I kind of like to see at least 30 minutes of filming time and plenty of standby time, but it is what it is. It's got a nice, easy tactile button here for pushing to start recording and to stop recording. So that's good. The battery door kind of impedes. So this is the thumb screw that came with it. This is the mount that came with it. There's a little safety gate right there, and the battery door opens. So there's a little bit of drag on that. Not a big deal. And then the battery just slides on out. And surprisingly, the battery's not super warm, so a lot of the heat that's generated is coming from the rear LCD touchscreen. So, GoPro, bring back the Session 5 or make it the Session 8, whatever. You know, I've heard a lot of great things about that. Because it doesn't have the touch screen, it doesn't require all that energy to keep this running. You do it all through your cell phone anyways, right? Like, ditch that. I really don't think it's necessary anymore. Antiquated. Okay, well, let's wrap this up. I had a good time kind of playing with things. Hopefully I didn't rattle on too long. More first impressions. This door, it hinges off. I'm sure most of you have seen that on other reviews. So I don't know, people compare things. I don't have anything to compare it to. So I don't have a problem with it. It hinges off easily, it hinges back on. It feels like it's made out of machined aluminum. And I'm excited about the trip. So thanks for joining me on my quick review of the GoPro Hero 8. And some old nostalgic pieces. The original Hero with the old walleye lens. I don't even think this thing turns on anymore. But yeah. If you have any questions, comments, concerns, put them in that little chat box down below. I do my best to answer everybody's questions, comments, and concerns. Let me know what you're thinking. If you want me to do more review videos, or if you want me to do less videos like this, just give me a shout. And definitely click that subscribe button. I really appreciate all of my fans who are out there watching my videos and you know, putting in the work to comment and keep the inspiration alive. So hopefully you enjoyed the trip. And I know I did. I haven't even gone yet, but I'm going to have a good time. So I'm glad that you guys come along with me on these helicopter adventures. Until next time, my name is Rick. This is Left Coast Overland in my helipilot office. Thanks for joining me. We'll see you out there. Bye-bye.
Clear.
Ensenada, B.C. California. It's been raining here all day. Clouds were low, came in along the coast. Northbound is clear, southbound not so much. Glad I had to come here, nowhere further. Worked out really well. Well, get some gas, we'll reposition, and then we'll tidy up for the afternoon. Get this party started. This baby's all packed up for the night. Look at that, the sun came out. It's beautiful. It's hot too, I had to take off my sweatshirt.